Good morning, you guys. Welcome to Children's Ministry Sunday Worship. Glad you're joining me here today. I hope you guys had a wonderful week. Before we begin our worship time, let's prepare our hearts and pray. We're going to pray for the three things we normally do, right? First, we're going to confess any sin we need to confess before God, right? We want to make our hearts right with Him before we come into worship. Second, we're going to thank God for all the wonderful things He's done for us, how He's protected us, how He's always provided for us. We're going to thank Him for all the good things that He has given to us, remembering His goodness and His faithfulness. And so let's praise Him and thank Him. And then lastly, the third thing, we're going to ask God to quiet our minds and our hearts so that we can hear what He wants to teach us today. So ask Him, God, please open up my ears and my heart so that I can hear what You want to teach me today. All right, guys, so I'll give you guys time to pray, and then I'll open us up in prayer. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we thank You so much for this past week. We thank You for protecting us from the storm, and we thank You for our homes and our parents who take good care of us, especially during these times. And Lord, we also thank You for the rain and watering this whole earth. Lord, we just want to lift up this worship time unto You. Would You quiet our thoughts? Would You quiet all distractions that, you know, are popping into our minds right now so that we can focus on You and on Your word, what You want to teach us today. Help us to understand what You're trying to teach us today as well. We thank You so much for Your love and Your goodness. Thank You for always protecting us and being with us. Would You continue to protect our families and be with us? Thank You, and in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. All right, guys, let's stand up and have a time of praise.
I'm feeling good, good, good in a crazy way. God's love changed me more than I can say. Can't keep this in, gotta let it out. Gonna tell the whole world that Your love is spinning me round and around. Yeah, it's turning me upside down. I can't believe the way You love me more than I can contain. I'm gonna turn around and give it away.
All right, so last week, right, we read about how Peter taught the believers and Christians and even us how to continue to live like Jesus and grow to be more like him. So today, and for the next few weeks, we're going to focus on the early church. Remember, the Holy Spirit came on top of the disciples and the apostles, and they were empowered to share the good news of Jesus rising again from the dead, forgiving us of our sins, right? They were empowered to share this message, and many came to believe. And so we're going to see how the early churches were formed as these peoples turned away from their sin and came to believe. So let's watch this video together, and we'll dig a little bit deeper.
The early church was growing. By the power of the Holy Spirit, the apostles were telling people that Jesus had been raised from the dead. A large group of believers met together in Jerusalem. They shared everything they had. If someone had more than he needed, he gladly gave it away so everyone had what he needed. One man, Barnabas, sold a field and gave the money to the apostles. The apostles used the money to help people in need. Everyone who had land or houses did the same. Ananias and his wife, Sapphira, sold some land and pretended to give all of the money to the apostles, but they kept some of it for themselves. When Ananias brought the money to the apostles, Peter asked him, "Why are you lying to the Holy Spirit? You could have been honest about what you did with the money, but instead you lied, not to us, but to God." When Ananias heard this, he fell down, died, and was buried. Everyone who heard about this was filled with fear. About 3 hours later, Sapphira came to the apostles. She did not know what had happened to her husband. Peter asked her, "Is this all the money you got for the land?" "Yes," she said, "that's all of it." Peter said, "Why did you and your husband agree to test the Lord?" Then Sapphira fell dead too. Great fear came on everyone in the church and all who heard about these things. Ananias and Sapphira wanted to look generous, but they were greedy. The Holy Spirit changes our hearts to want to share with those in need because Jesus generously gave all he had so we can share in his riches and have forgiveness and eternal life.
All right, so in our study of the early church today, we met Ananias and Sapphira, right? And so let's read what happened. Okay, we're going to read two sections. We're going to read Acts 4 and a part of Acts 5. Okay, so let's read these together, starting from Acts chapter 4, verse 32 through 35. Ready? Begin. All the believers were one in heart and mind. No one claimed that any of their possessions was their own, but they shared everything they had. With great power, the apostles continued to testify to the resurrection of the Lord Jesus. And God's grace was so powerfully at work in them all, that there were no needy persons among them. For from time to time, those who owned land or houses sold them, brought the money from the sales, and put it at the apostles' feet, and it was distributed to anyone who had need. Now, this is Acts chapter 5, where we learn about Ananias and Sapphira. Let's read this together. Acts chapter 5, verse 1 through 4. Now a man named Ananias, together with his wife Sapphira, also sold a piece of property. With his wife's full knowledge, he kept back part of the money for himself, but brought the rest and put it at the apostles' feet. Then Peter said, "Ananias, how is it that Satan has so filled your heart that you have lied to the Holy Spirit and have kept for yourself some of the money you received for the land? Didn't it belong to you before it was sold? And after it was sold, wasn't the money at your disposal? What made you think of doing such a thing? You have not lied just to human beings, but to God. And after this, he drops dead. And then 3 hours later, Sapphira comes and Peter asks, is this all the money from the land? And Sapphira says, yes, right? And Peter says, oh, you've lied against God. You've lied to God. And so it will be just like, so it be to you just like your husband. And she also drops dead. So I know some part of this story is very surprising, but there's a few points before I get into Ananias and Sapphira. First thing is, the early church, right, the early believers, they shared everything they had and gave to those who were in need. They were so filled with love and grace that from Jesus Christ, they said, I've got to give. I've got to give just like Jesus has given to me. I want to, I want to love and have compassion on people just like how Jesus had compassion on us. And this strengthened the message of the gospel. When people saw the early Christians share and give, they said, wow, this is amazing. Jesus has really changed them. I want to know more about, you know, this Jesus who changes them and makes them want to share their things, even sell their property and distribute the money to those who need it. Now, Ananias and Sapphira, they also had some land. And they thought, okay, we'll sell the land and we'll take some of the money and tell them that we gave all the money to them, right? And so they lied. They were tempted by their greed and lied before God. And therefore, right, they dropped dead. Now, this is not to say if you lie before God or lie to God or sin against God that you're just going to drop dead like that. No, this is a specific and very special story, right, that happened in the past and doesn't mean that it's going to happen to you, okay? But what we need to understand is Ananias and Sapphira, they didn't have to lie, right? They didn't have to say, oh, this is all the money. They could have said, oh, this is just some of the money from our property. They didn't have to, you know, lie to God, but they did, right? Because they were tempted by their greed and they wanted people to see them as, wow, what wonderful people by giving their money, right? So they were tempted by their greed and it led them to lie before God. Now, we need to all understand that we all struggle with sin, right? We all struggle with greed and pride, just like Ananias and Sapphira did. But I want to tell you guys that we don't need to lie to God, right? We don't need to pretend. We don't need to fake things, right? God doesn't want our fake hearts. God doesn't want our lies. He wants our truth, right? And even if we have a problem of giving things away, Jesus forgives us of our greed, and he's the one that changes our hearts through the Holy Spirit when we are being honest and true about it, right? And you know, we all struggle with greed, right? It's not just about money, but we're selfish with our time, right? We're greedy with our toys, we're greedy with our snacks and our candies, right? Sometimes if your sibling is like, can I have one? Then you count, no, I only have 3 left. You can't have one, right? Because you're like, this is precious candy to me. You can't have any, right? Sometimes we can be like that. And that's a piece of greed, right? It may not be as big as Ananias and Sapphira, but we still have greed, right? We still struggle with greed. And even with time, right? We're greedy with our time. We don't want to give people our time because we want to do what we want to do. I don't care what you need or what you want me to do. I'm going to do what I want. And what I want to do is play games or play with my toys or read. This is what I want to do, right? I don't want to have to help, you know, help my mom clean up or, you know, help my dad set up the table or, you know, whatever they are asking you, right? We can be greedy with a lot of different things. And money is a big one, right? But just because we have that problem, it doesn't mean we should lie. Not that we can't even lie to God. God knows when we're lying to him, right? When we're being honest and saying, God, it's hard for me to give up, you know, some of the things that I have, some of the toys that I have. It's hard for me to, you know, give it up. It's hard for me to give the snacks that I have. It's hard for me to give my time up. And you're honest with God and you ask him for forgiveness, saying sorry for being so greedy and not wanting to share generously as you have. Then God, right, he sees and understands. He forgives us. Jesus forgives us when we say, I'm so sorry for being so greedy, when Jesus, you sacrificed your life, right? When we say that, Jesus forgives us. And then the Holy Spirit comes in and helps us, changes our hearts so that we can be generous like Jesus, right? Like some of the people of the early church, they felt so much love from Jesus, so thankful for what he did, that out of their love and thankfulness, they gave freely, they gave generously. And some people, it takes a little bit longer, and that is okay, right? It's okay. We all struggle with sin, with greed, with pride, and many other sin. And when we are just honest with God, when we're honest before Jesus, and we say, this is what I'm struggling with, I'm sorry, Jesus forgives us, and the Holy Spirit changes our hearts to become more like Jesus. So, I want you to remember, today's lesson is not about if you sin, you're going to drop dead. That's not today's lesson. Today's lesson is, you don't have to lie before God. Be honest with what you're struggling with. Ask for forgiveness and ask the Holy Spirit to change your heart to become more generous, more loving, more compassionate like Jesus. And you know what? Jesus hears us and he changes our hearts. The Holy Spirit is working in there to make us become more like Jesus. And so give your hearts to Jesus today. Be honest with him. Don't be afraid. Okay? He's not gonna just say, you know what, you did it again, that's it, get rid of, you know, I'm done with you. No. Jesus welcomes us in and he says, I forgive you and I now will change your heart. All right, guys, let's end with the Lord's Prayer. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who have sinned against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For yours is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen. All right, guys. Hope you guys have a wonderful week. Stay safe, stay dry, and have a wonderful family time. Good luck in school, and I'll see you guys again next time. Bye.